I'm Cassie, one half of the DIY sisters, and this week I'm showing you my cottagecore kitchen transformation. Don't forget to like and subscribe. We have a ton of room makeover videos coming up, so you don't want to miss it. Now let's dive in. I'm Caitlin.
And I'm Kathy.
And we're the DIY sisters. As you can see, the kitchen had amazing bones. The original back door was very cool, but it had like a giant crack in it. So before I closed the house, the owners replaced it with an old door I found at the antique salvage shop. I love the window. And fun fact, you know that it's old glass when it has that wavy technique to it. People comment on it all the time when they come in my house, and I just think it's such a fun thing. The cabinets were handmade by the previous owner, and my dad is actually a dendrologist, which means tree ring scientist. So here's what he had to say about them.
This is Pecky cypress that was part of sinker logs. It was pulled out of the marsh or canals, and over time, worms that can dig into the hole of the wood underwater create these little holes to, it just means it's old cypress, virgin cypress that has been salvaged. So.
Here are my initial thoughts. Love the wood. Love the beams. Love the beadboard on the ceiling. Liked the countertops. Despised the wallpaper. It looks much dingier in person than it does in this footage, I promise. And it really just clashed with all the wood, and it really clashed with the countertops. So I just knew I had to do something. I had an idea. Kitchen reno, day one. We've been doing all the boring stuff for like weeks now. Caulking everything, painting interior cabinets, like the nuts and bolts, not the fun stuff. So this is the first start of the fun stuff. As you can see behind me, we have some plaid wallpaper. This has got to go. So I made up a technique. I've seen so many people use joint compound to like give things this really cool stone effect. And I was like, can I put that on a wall? And I looked it up, and there's one blog I found. They had taken a trowel with joint compound and done like kind of like a spackling look on the wall. I was like, what if I put on gloves and just kind of like hand pressed the joint compound on the wall? Turns out it was super fun. I did a test patch behind my fridge, and it was really fun to do, and I like the look of it. I'm never gonna exactly get the whole look that I want, which is like an Irish cottage, English cottage type of texture. We're gonna get as close to sort of an interesting plaster textural look for $15. So let's get started. Okay, so I just did this, so that's why it's gray, but it's already looking so cottagey. I love it so much. And by the way, what you're seeing is just the joint compound. I didn't paint it, I didn't seal it. So far, there are no stains, no crumbling, no problems. And it's just been over a year now, so we'll see how it goes. Kitchen. So I have finished the texture on the walls. It looks great. Might want to go over it and do something different or interesting, or you know, stuff like that. I just need to patch up a few spots. So I'll work on that later. I purchased a baker's rack to work as sort of a coffee bar type situation, but I'm not really in love with it. I mean, it's okay. I'm going to make it work, because I spent too much money on it and I don't know why, I was an impulse buy. But I'm gonna try to make that work as a coffee bar and try to like make it look really cute and hang some things on it. Here is the coffee bar baker's rack in question. It's not terrible, it's just not exactly my style. Like, it's obviously not meant to be a coffee bar. It's a little big, but it's okay with the walkway. I think I'm gonna hang coffee cups from here and then maybe wine glasses on the other side and then just get some accessories. This is my little Keurig coffee pot and Keurig, which is great for Airbnb guests. So yeah, let's get to it. So I paint stripped and sanded a piece of wood that I salvaged from one of my closets and used that as like the base for the coffee bar. And then I removed the shelf above where the coffee is gonna go so that it has the space. I bought this wine rack from Amazon and screwed it into the metal shelf above. I purchased the wine glasses for 25 cents a piece, baby, from a local thrift shop. Gotta love it, gotta love it. Then I purchased shower hooks and used them to hang coffee cups. These cups are from the Hand and Hearth at Target, by the way. I found this spice rack from the Salvation Army for $3 and restained it in the color Early American and added my K-cups to it. Lastly, I put everything into jars. Sugar, creamer, Splenda, teaspoons, which my friend gave to me, by the way. And I'm so grateful because I love them. And I also thrifted this coffee jar from Salvation Army for $2 where I put in the coffee grounds. I added a few baskets on the bottom shelf with tea, coffee filters, etc. And the coffee bar was done. This is a wall that, like, I'm really not sure what to do with because, I mean, I guess it needs a shelf, but the way that everything is arranged, it's gonna be sort of an awkward looking shelf. Right now it's just sort of a blank wall. Next, my mom helped me hang the shelf, but it was just so small and puny. I ended up finding one at the ReStore not too long after for $5, and it's a much better size for the space. And then I just added thrifted finds and these little wooden spoons that I kind of stained and aged myself and put it all together. This at a thrift shop, I'm not even kidding you, for $5. So a friend of mine had a giant, these giant mason jars. So I don't know if you saw, but I made these like wooden spoons. You could see I like burnt some of them and all that good stuff. And I got this also at a thrift store, probably for like $3. I never pay more than the most I'll pay for something like this is usually $5. So I have like a little vial that you would find, and maybe this fell off of something. So I was like, maybe I can like, I don't know if that looks stupid. And I got this copper pan.
And it already had this string on it, so I was like, oh, I'll just like hang it up.
How do you keep it still?
I got this from IKEA. I got a bunch of them. And then hang it like so. Does that look stupid? That's not bad.
So far, I think this is cute. Right? And I put that up the other day, by the way. Cute.
Next, I didn't have enough room for these oven mitts in my drawers, so I wanted to add a little bar next to the oven so that I can hang them. I found this gold bar on Amazon for $8.99. I screwed in gold C hooks under the countertop and molded it around the gold bar so that was like nice and snug. Then I just used rub and buff on the same black shower hooks and added my oven mitts. The oven mitts are from Dollar Tree. Now onto the window. I wanted to give it that cottage witch look with all the dried flowers. So I went to Hobby Lobby on a sale day, of course, and picked out a few dried flowers and a few faux stems. I was concerned about the longevity and cleanliness, particularly with something like dried lavender. I just felt like it would end up falling apart. I don't know, but I think the faux lavender is still kind of cute. I simply wrapped the twine around the middle of the flowers and made sure to tie a little hook onto it so I could just hang the hook on the nail on the top of the window. I added some finishing touches. Thrifted finds on the windowsill, including a bouquet of fake flowers. A rug I ordered on Etsy from Turkey. It was only $47, by the way. Another rug I picked up from Target. Just need some time. I hung a wreath on the cabinet that hides the hot water heater. Different baskets on the wooden beam for that cottagecore feel. I know now you'll never change your mind. A cinnamon broom on the door frame for more witchy vibes. And three matching frames I thrifted with cottage looking artwork inside. You do not know what I have in mind. That leads us to today. It's been about a year now since all of these renovations have been done. I'm not gonna lie, half of what you just saw was a year ago, and the other half was me like 5 minutes ago. But there are a couple tweaks that I wanna do. First of all, I'd like to put up all the breadboards that I created. I'm not sure where yet, but I wanna put them up somewhere on the walls. Secondly, I want to replace the soap with something cuter. I'd like to add more flowers to this windowsill to create a fuller, more cottagey look. And lastly, I might want to put up these cinnamon brooms. I got them for $3 a piece at a flea market. I used them during my medieval Christmas makeover, and I definitely want to hold on to them because I'm definitely gonna use them for Halloween, baby. That's gonna happen. So I might put them somewhere in this kitchen. We'll see about that. So let's get into it. First up, the breadboards. If you haven't watched my Olive Atelier's dupe video, go watch that after this, but I'll show you a brief version of how I created these.
And I also found this pizza board at the thrift store for $3.99, by the way. So I just sanded it and stained it to match the others.
Plot twist. I have COVID. I'm really happy that I woke up today and I don't feel like a miserable death, like I could stand. I took out the trash today. This is my third time that we go in also. Third time having COVID, fully vaccinated, boosted. My immunity basically has short-term memory loss. I'm gonna stop talking because I feel like I sound atrocious and I want you to see me as little as possible today. I don't even know what I'm doing with these breadboards, but. Seconds. I'm so tired. I thought I figured out a plan, but then I hated the way it looked when it was up. So I basically just made a million holes in my wall as I experimented with things. Patch up all of those other holes. Goodness gracious. I'm still not totally sold on it, so send any ideas my way if you have them. Now let's replace this dollar store soap dispenser with a cute amber glass one. I purchased this on Amazon originally for my bathroom, came in a 4-pack, and it included the labels. Simple change, but very effective, and I don't know why I didn't do it like before. I've had that sitting in my closet. Then I headed to Michael's to pick up more flowers for above the windowsill.
These just look like so fake in person. It just doesn't look right when it's bundled like this. Fullness of the eucalyptus, but I think it should replace the olive. Let's go do that. Question is this a fire hazard? I might have to maybe scale it down a little bit. Because I made all of this so much fuller, I feel like it doesn't need that bigness over here anymore like I was looking for, so I feel like it's good that it's over there. So I found these at a flea market for $3 a pop, and I purchased them for my Christmas medieval fireplace makeover. Link to that video below. I'll definitely be using them for Halloween decor this year, so I just maybe want to hang them up where I can easily take them down. I don't know.
What if I put magnets on the brooms and then put them on the fridge? And that way it's like, instead of just a white blank fridge, there's some like witchy brooms.
And with that final fail, let's go to the reveal. Love how it turned out. The kitchen is the heart of the home, and my heart is a cottage witch. Truly. Don't forget to like and subscribe. We have so many more room makeovers coming your way, and Caitlin will see you next Wednesday. Bye.
Fake laughter.
Why?
Kitty! Hi, kitty! Oh my gosh. Kitty, kitty.